Hello and once again welcome back. This is Richard and I'm today gonna show you how to do a slidey dough with all its slidey goodness. So let's get into that. Here we go. All right then, we're in Unreal and in a reasonable folder. I don't know what reasonable folder means. In a folder, choose your folder and we're gonna right click and select blueprint class and actor. And I'm gonna call this a BP underscore door sliding. And I call this single because I'm gonna do a double afterwards. So open that up and in here we're gonna add static mesh. We're gonna call it door. And then we're gonna add a box collision. Call it, I like to call mine trigger. And I like to also add an arrow. If you know me from my previous videos, I like arrows. So there's, select the door, go over here, and we are gonna type in door and select SM door. You have to have the default content or whatever they call it, starter kit, in your project to get the door. Unless you've got your own door, then use that. If you haven't got it, then you can get it by clicking add new up here, feature or content pack, and then you can choose content pack, start the content, add the project, and Bob's your uncle, you have the door in there. So here's our door so far. Let's get our box trigger and just set that up right now, because I know I'll forget to do it later if I leave it. I'll just do it like that. I'll do. Right. Event graph. So in the event graph, we're going to delete all of that. Right, there you go. I'm having problems with my keyboard tonight, so bear with me. So with that deleted, we're going to select our trigger. We're going to go down, begin overlap. We're going to select it again, end overlap. And then we're going to pull out. And we're going to get a timeline, because we all love timelines. I'm going to call it open door. Call it whatever you like. It doesn't matter. By the way, we're going to grab our door. And we are going to just make note. Everything up here in the location is zeroed. So that's easy to remember. When we slide this to the position we want, let's say to there, a Y changes to 85, so we can copy that or remember it. It's not hard to remember at this point. Let's put it back to zero, and then what we want to do is double click our timeline, add a vector, and call this door open or whatever you like, open door, whatever. And we're only using the Y, so we can lock off the X, lock off the Z, right click, add key to Y. And the time is going to be 0, and the value will be 0 also. By the way, up here when it says length, change that to like 1.5, I think 2 is a bit long for a simple door. Anyway, right click again, add key to Y again. This time we're going to go to 1.5 because that's what we put up there. And then over here, we're going to put 85 because that's the value we had earlier. So that is it. You can click those two buttons and get a visual. And then back to your event graph. And over here, so all you need to do is pull out from the update and click set relative location. And it's got door in brackets, relative location. Click that one. Select the yellow pin, drag that into that yellow pin, and you're done. And then grab our end overlap, pull that into the reverse, and that is it. Look how simple that code is. And if we hit play, I don't have it in my scene. Always forget this. And I need to turn it around, because my arrow's pointing the wrong way. I don't need to turn it around, but I like to have it facing the right way. Press play, I can go up to it. And the door slides to the left. And then come out, slides to the right. And freeze. See it? That's how it's done. Leave the box. And it closes. Awesome. So that is it, basically, guys. Nice and simple. And I'm going to just slide this into this spot right here because I got a bit of a door collection going on. Oh man, what's going on here? In the middle. There you go. So now I have, oh man. Right, it's getting dark. Since I started recording this video, the sun's gone down. So we got a bit of a door collection going on here. I got doors everywhere. I got one at the light over there. So we can go over here and it opens. If you watched my last video, we got the bifold open door thing, whatever you call that. And that's it. I'm just going to turn my light on just for fun. That's it. Next, I'm going to do double slidey doors like we did here with the double rotation. Except we're going to do double slidey doors. Not that there's much difference. It's pretty much exactly the same, except you're changing the location rather than the rotation. Anyway, I'll do that just in case you want to see it. So, see you soon. Ciao, blau.